Welcome back again to my channel. As always, I post a new video every Friday, so if you're interested in art-related videos and you haven't already, please consider subscribing. I would really appreciate it. So today's video is going to be a little bit more on the informative side because I do like to answer your questions and give my perspective. So as the title says, for today's video, we are doing how to be a successful artist online. I've narrowed it down to 5 tips because I feel like there's a lot I could say about this one topic. I think there's a lot of different aspects to it, so I'm just gonna go into my top five tips on how to be a successful artist online. When I say online, what I mean by that is now that social media exists and it's a lot easier to get your artwork out online and in front of other people, there are a lot of ways that you can utilize the internet and social media to get yourself out there as an artist. Today is going to be how to get yourself out there, how to get noticed, how to be successful. Let's just get right into it because I'm excited to share my tips with you. So tip number one, which I think definitively is the most important tip as an artist online, utilizing social media. That is extremely important to get yourself out there. There are various platforms that you can use, but you know, nowadays everything is pretty much online and it's the best resource that you can use to get yourself out there to the largest number of people the quickest. So my primary recommendation for a platform to use as an artist is Instagram. That should be your, you know, definitely part of your arsenal of platforms that you use. Just because Instagram is extremely easy to share your images, it's focused around photos and images, so it's the best to get your stuff out there because you're going to be taking pictures of your artwork, you're going to be uploading images of your artwork, so, you know, why not use an image platform? You can also use the hashtag system. Definitely use hashtags when you post. I mean, to not use hashtags is a bad idea because using hashtags is the best way to get your artwork out there to new audiences and people that might not find you other ways. So you also have the chance, if you hit the algorithm correctly, it's really random on Instagram, but you have always the chance to get your artwork pushed out to the Explore page, which a lot of people that are not following you, they'll be able to find you from there. So hashtagging is extremely important if you want other people to find you. There's also other platforms you can use like Twitter. Twitter is really good for sharing your thoughts or your updates with your followers since it's really text-based, but you can also post images on there. You can also post your artwork or link to your other social media platforms. Like if you use YouTube, you can link to your videos. So that's also a good option to have. I think Instagram should be your primary, but Twitter, if you don't want to use Instagram, or if you want to use, you know, just two platforms maybe that are the best options, Instagram and Twitter, I think, are the top. Then there's YouTube, which obviously I use YouTube, but YouTube was something that came way after. Instagram was my first platform, and then there was YouTube, because YouTube's a lot more time-consuming. You have to be dedicated to video making, so it's a whole different thing. It's not just drawing an image and posting it, it's creating videos and content, so that's another thing you could do to get yourself out there. But it is a lot more time consuming and you have to be more dedicated to wanting to do that. It's also a little harder to get noticed just because the hashtagging system is not the same as those other two platforms I mentioned. And but in the end, if you do choose YouTube at all, it can be very rewarding. It can lead to a full-time job in the future in the long run, but it is also extremely variable depending on the amount of views you get. You know, you can monetize your videos, but again, you have to be over a certain threshold of followers, I think, now. I don't know how they changed it a bit, but you either have to be over a certain amount of views or a certain amount of subscribers. So, yeah. YouTube's a little iffy if you're starting off. I don't know if I would start off on YouTube unless you want to do videos. But if you want to just get your artwork out there generally, definitely start maybe with Instagram or Twitter. It's the best and quickest way to get your artwork out there to an audience. And then if you want to also create YouTube videos, once you have an audience on one of those other platforms, you can kind of push it to them and see if they want to follow you there, and then just build it from there. So definitely those are my top three social media platforms, and it's essential to have at least one of them to be successful online. So tip number two is to post consistently. One of the major things that can kill off somebody's, Instagram account or their YouTube channel is if you just disappear and you're posting maybe once every 6 months, you're posting a picture or a video once every, you know, month or two, like it, or maybe 1 week you post and then you don't post again for 3 weeks, and then you don't post again for 5 months, and then you post again the next week, like it's super variable. People like consistency. So if you kind of try to stick to some sort of upload schedule, you definitely have a better shot. People like consistency. For example, if you're just starting off, you know, you can try posting maybe once per week. It's not too much of a commitment, and it also kind of keeps you on your own little schedule. Definitely posting consistently on some sort of schedule. It doesn't even have to be the same day every week or something like that. It can be just posting a few times a week. Just making sure you're staying active and you're consistently posting, or you're following some sort of schedule. So the more you post online, or the more, I guess, you stick to a schedule, the more engagement you'll get. If you're on a schedule specifically, like posting once a week or maybe once a day if you have a lot of time, you'll definitely stick in people's minds more. They'll remember to visit your page. They're not going to forget about you. Definitely keep it consistently in some way. Tip number three is to choose a topic. So by choosing a topic, I mean a topic to center your page or your channel around. So if you want to get noticed as an artist, definitely do not clog your feed with random things that have absolutely nothing to do with you as an artist. So if you're posting, you know, sketches and drawings, don't go posting like random pictures of cars or pictures of, you know, you at the grocery store or, I don't know, vegetables. Like, don't post random things that have nothing to do with your content. You can make a separate account for that. I know that I have a separate account that I use for all of my shop stuff specifically. And of course, you can post stuff about your life and updates like that too. People do like to see that. You can use your Instagram as like a behind the scenes kind of thing. You can post yourself, but just don't post completely random things. People want to see a consistent topic. So tip number four is to have a website. It's super easy to set a website up and free, so I don't know why you wouldn't, especially if you want to get yourself out there. But there's a variety of benefits from having a website as an artist. First of all, it makes you look very professional and can set you apart from others. So you definitely would want to have that for that purpose. But also you can use it as a portfolio. As you guys know, I have a Wix website. I've always used Wix to create my website. And I found them a few years ago and been using them ever since. They're also super awesome. They sponsored a previous video. They're just great. So I'm going to promote that website platform just because it's my favorite. And there's also a link in my description box if you want to create your own Wix website. But generally, a portfolio is really, really handy for applications to different things. So whether you have an application for a job and they want to see a portfolio, or you have an application, maybe you're applying to artist alleys. That's what I do. I apply to different anime conventions. They want to see a portfolio. I give them this link to my website page and they can see all of my newest artwork, all my best artwork that I post on here that I want them to see. And then it goes from there. So that's really useful, especially since a lot of them, they don't want to see your Instagram page. They don't want to see your Etsy shop. That's too confusing. They just want to see a website that has all of your artwork on it. So that is definitely a no-brainer. You should definitely have a portfolio as an artist. You can also use it as a main hub for all of your links, which I do as well. At the top of the website, you can have a navigation bar where, say, you have an Instagram, you have a Twitter, maybe you have a Patreon, you have a YouTube, you have a shop. You want to include everything in one place so you can just give people one link and they can find all of your stuff there. That's definitely a good reason to have a website. So I do the same thing on mine. At the top of my portfolio page, I keep my Instagram, I keep my YouTube, etc. All of my stuff's at the top. So if I want people to find my stuff, I just give them the link to my website and I say, oh, you can check me out in all these different places from my site. So that's definitely a really good thing to have, a really good resource is a website. And like I said, using Wix, especially as a beginner, even if you're really advanced, like you can really take advantage of a lot of the stuff they have on Wix. But I know when I was starting off making my first website, I was a little confused on how to do it, and using Wix, it was super easy. All self-explanatory. Having a website as an artist makes you look professional. You can use it as a resource in a portfolio, or you can just keep it as something that is a convenience for all of your links together to give people and get yourself out there. So That's what I have to say about websites. Super important. Definitely do that. So my final tip for today is to network with and support other artists. Making friends with other artists is very important in the art community. It's first of all great just to have a support system and people you can talk to whenever you have questions or problems. That's definitely a great resource and a great option. I love all of the people that I'm friends with that I've met through the art community. It's just a great thing to have. So definitely make some friends with artists. It's great to support each other and sometimes even just make connections for different things. Maybe they have some information on, you know, where to get a certain thing or how they did a certain thing, and you know, you guys can share tips with each other. So that's always a good idea. And then you can also do art trades or collabs with different artists. Collabs are beneficial, collabs or trades, they're beneficial to both you and the other artist, because while they are fun to do, they also help to get both of your own name and your work out to a larger audience. So, you know, you'll get your artwork or your name out to their audience and they'll get their things out to your audience. So it's beneficial for both artists and definitely a good idea when you're trying to build a name for yourself online is to befriend different artists. Maybe you guys can do some trades or collabs, have a bit of fun, and also help each other out in the process. So yeah, supporting other artists, you can make long-term friendships and just get tips on various things that you might need tips on. So definitely befriend other people in the art community. It's also just a great thing to do. It's a great thing to have friends and people that support your artwork. So do that. I really, really recommend that. This is a very important tip. So that's all I'm gonna say for how to be a successful artist online. I really hope that these tips helped you all in some way.
Those are my 5 tips on how to be a successful artist online. There is never a guarantee, so I'm not saying by doing these 5 things you're definitely going to be successful online like right away. It might take some time, and I think that sometimes there's different factors at play. Sometimes it has to do with timing, sometimes it has to do with a little bit of luck, or sometimes it just takes a while to build things up. So I think that if you follow these 5 tips and you keep them in mind, you can definitely get there eventually. And I wish you guys all the best of luck online, getting your artwork out there, improving your artwork, all of that. So thank you guys so much for watching my video today. If you have any other questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'd love to answer them and take a look at them, and maybe somebody else has the same question as well. As always, all of my links are in the description box below. I've got the link to my online shop where I have pins, charms, prints, everything that I create is there. I also have the link to my Instagram account. I post things that I don't post here on the channel, such as artwork I'm working on or things that I just don't upload here. And then I also have the link to My Amino. If you want to download that app, you can. And you can become a part of My Amino, which is a community where you can post your own artwork, polls, quizzes, chat rooms, all of that. And I hang out there a lot. I also have a fan club there, so go check it out. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I will see you all next week. I post every Friday at 4 p.m. Eastern time and hope to see you guys there. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.